Welcome to this week's podcast. I'm Tim Weigel. I'm the team leader for the Lake Erie Regional Grape Program and also the statewide grape and hops IPM specialist. It's the first week in August, and it's that time of year where we're really worried about spotted lanternfly hitchhiking into our area. Right now, there's no known infestations in New York State. We'd like to keep it that way, but we saw last year about this time where we started to see more and more of the adults coming in, hitchhiking their way in just with personal vehicles or shipments coming up. They love to fly. They're kind of clumsy flyers, but they're still good at it, and they'll go into any open window, the back of a box van, something like that, and then they come right up into New York State. So what can we do about it? We want to know how to identify all the major stages, but right now, especially the adult stage, because once we get into August, they're moving from the fourth instar nymph into the adult stage. So you can see the picture that's flashing up here on the screen now. This is an adult. You see it typically, a lot of times they'll show it with the wings open. You can see the red underwings. It's a very beautiful insect, but you're typically going to find it with the wings closed when it's resting or feeding on the tree. So where do we look for these things? They will love the tree of heaven. So one of the things that I have been doing is going around and trying to find tree of heaven in the local area and use that as a monitoring tool. So tree of heaven, if you're looking for it, it looks a lot like a sumac. It has the compound leaves. And here's a tree of heaven, and you can see it has the large compound leaves. And the difference between this and sumac is a real easy way to tell is if you look at the leaf margin, it's smooth. There's a lobe at the end of the leaf or the basal part of the leaf. And also if you crush the leaf or break the stem here and smell it, you get a rancid odor. It smells in like cat urine or rancid peanut butter, things like that. Looks a lot like sumac, so you'll have to go in and check that. But the fourth instar and the adult gravitate toward the tree of heaven, and they do their feeding there. So if you can find a tree of heaven in your area, it's a good place to, just as you're taking your daily walk, go by and check it. They love to go up and down the tree trunks. So another identifying feature of tree of heaven is that the trunks, you can see here and here, the trunks look a lot like a cantaloupe rind. And so it's easy to help distinguish between a sumac, which typically does not get this nice big trunk and the woody part, and also like another tree species that it can be misidentified for is black walnut. Obviously there's no nuts on the ailanthus, and also the bark is a lot smoother than on a black walnut. Sometimes black walnut is mistaken for tree of heaven or vice versa because of the compound leaves, but the black walnut leaf, if you look at it, has a serrated edge to the leaf margin rather than the smooth edge that the tree of heaven does. And of course, this time of year in August, the black walnut typically will have some actual walnuts starting to form up on the tree. And again, the trunk, the bark on the trunk is much coarser than what we would find on the tree of heaven. Tree of heaven has both male and female trees, and the spotted lanternfly doesn't have a preference, it doesn't seem. They'll feed on both of them. But this is one of the things, the seeds that you can see both behind me here and then in the foreground. Seeds are what makes this where it can just take off. And where we were at with all the male trees, they actually came from the females that were about two blocks away, and the seeds flying out there. people have asked, should I cut down the ailanthus if I find it? Right now, New York State, we're not suggesting that you try and remove tree of heaven because it's pretty extensive in some areas, but rather we're using it as a monitoring tool. So if you find tree of heaven, keep your eye on it, just keep walking by, because this time of year, spotted lanternfly will be attracted to it. And you can see here on the river edge, tree of heaven will grow pretty much the same places as sumac will. In disturbed sites, they love creek beds, but you can see the difference in the leaves. This tree of heaven, it has the smooth leaf edges. Sometimes the compound leaves can get up to 3 foot long. With the sumac, the younger ones, you can see that the big difference is leaflets are a little narrower, and they also have the serrated edges, and they don't have the lobes at the basal part of the leaf. So be vigilant if you have anybody. Right now, the populations are centered down in southeast PA, the counties in New Jersey, Maryland, Delaware, that are right there in the border southeast PA. So if you know of anybody that's coming up from the quarantine zone, then you can ask them to check out their car, make sure they're not bringing spotted lanternfly up with them. If you're purchasing anything from outside the area, that quarantine zone, make sure that when that delivery is made, that they have the permit required to bring materials out, and then also inspect the shipment to make sure that they're not bringing spotted lanternfly up into our area. So we do, I want to mention, we New York State IPM program has a spotted lanternfly conference that's coming up on August 15th in Binghamton, New York. For more information on that, you can follow the address here on the screen, so you can register and get more information with that. If you have any questions or comments, please let me know. And if you have any suggestions for future podcasts, please put them in the comment section below.